truly think there being such thing as a humane slaughterhouse. That there being something as humane slaughter. Think you that that exists? If you truly think that something like that exists, let me ask you then, be you also somebody that believe that there is something as an humane holocaust, or humane rape, humane child molestation, humane pedophilia, humane think that there be something as a humane murder, humane torture? No, because this is an oxymoron. There is not such thing as humane slaughter. There is not such thing as humane torture, abuse, rape, and all kind of this. Is an oxymoron and it have to stop. We have to stop with believing in fantasy land and thinking that there being something as that. The only moral choice is a veganism. Vegans don't eat eggs, milk, dairy and meats. Don't wear things like fur, silk, or pants, or fur, or anything that comes from another animal. Also, don't eat honey. Oysters and kind of this, or fish, if you think that this means something different as meat, and it means some kind of people. Vegans do that not because it is popular or for some health research. Vegans like me do this because they feel that it is the most moral thing to do. Veganism costs the least amount of suffering on the whole planet. Veganism saves a lot of fossil fuel from the seas to the income. Fossil fuel from the bottom of the sea. Because if you eat aquatic animals, they kill also other animals, large predators that been there to control the ecosystem of the sea. And then these animals eat from the fossil fuel and that being on the bottom of the sea, and that exchange a lot of the cobble about the sea from the CO2 from the sea, and that cost a lot of oxygen. And then we have less pretty world. And we destroy actually our whole habitat. And then also the shit of this all animals been enough to put the whole world on shit. And I put a lot of the shit of these animals in the sea. And then we polluting the seas, and now we have ocean dead zones. We destroy also a lot of of plankton in the sea, protoplanktons, that being actually some 70% of all the CO2 comes from the sea. 70% of all the CO2. We destroy most of the rainforest and all the other forests in order to take more and more and more land for the cattle. America alone, for the people that live in America, can feed the whole world. America can, according to the miracle of agriculture, feed something like 10 billion humans. The only reason that I don't can is because there have to be a vegan. Anybody in America has to be vegan to make that happen. That's how much land we take. That's how much. Can you imagine how much land we take and how much fuel the plants and how much rainforest being saved if we eat plants first? Understand that we neutralize our nutrients to somebody else's body. And also the people in poor countries that start from starvation because we steal all their food from them. All their foods we steal and put to our Western countries, to Europe, to America, to Sweden, to feed the animals, and that the children there start from starvation. Any two seconds, some children starve from starvation. And we eat here on this planet in this way, meat, dairy, and eggs, living like kings and queens of the Middle Ages, getting the diseases of kings and queens, acting like the barbaric kings and queens that steal from their people so that they can live a rich life. When comes the day that humanity awaken and adopt one vegan lifestyle, and human beings see themselves as something separate from the rest, an optional delusion of his consciousness. Our task must be to free ourselves from this illusion and spreading our compassion to any living beings. Not only a small amount of people close behind us, but actually to any living being, no matter which the race, no matter which the species, no matter which it be. Because any living being deserve their equal rights to be treated fairly, with respect. Humanity prays for mercy, but is not willing to extend it to others. It seems to me this way. So humanity deserve the respect from other living beings. It is unfair to ask for something that you don't be willing to give. It is inconsistent. I never will accept inconsistency and injustice. Even if it comes to from God, if God exists and tolerates this all, it will be put vengeance on God. if there comes a voice from God that he is against veganism, I will say, I being forward. That's how strong I being in this regard. If he wants to know what party you'll be on slavery, you have not watched further than on which party you'll be now on animal rights. I don't fear one animal planet. Because animals be far more kind than most humans. There be strange difference of maybe different traditions, but they've been willing to understand our traditions. Just like your cats and dogs, they've been willing to accept some of your traditions. Even there be not something that is from their kind. Because they've been far more acceptable and far more kind and rational than human beings. The only thing that vegans ask you is to stop with paying for the murder, torture and rape of other living beings, other living animals. That's the least that you can do from them. It is not your right, based on your traditions, your beliefs and your habits, to deny animals their freedom, so that you can harm them, slave them and rape them. That's not what rights are about. That's injustice. There is no counter-argument against veganism. Accept it, make a plea, and move forward. Evolve. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinter our way, and the true become visible.